There are people all over the world who don't believe that God is good. The world needs to know how good God is. Is there anybody here that knows that the Lord is absolutely, positively good? Psalm 106 says, "Praise the Lord. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good." The 107th Psalm says, "O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy." The psalmist David says, "I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast of the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be made glad." Then if I can fast forward, the psalmist comes back again and he says, "If you are not clear, I want to extend the invitation to you. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good." He is so good that the apostle Paul says, "All things work together for good to them that love God and are called according to his purpose." He is so good that even your bad is not out of his reach. He will even take what the devil meant for bad, flip it and reverse it and make it work out for your good. Even when you're going through, he's still good. Even with trials, he's still good. Even with tribulations, he's still good. Even with haters, he's still good. Even with heartache and heartbreak, he's still good. Because God can take it and mold it and make it and shape it and make it work together for your good. He's nothing but good. The only thing on his bio is good. The only thing on his resume is good. The only thing on his track record is good. And I need somebody who knows that he's good to open up your mouth and act like you know he is.
Why do we lift him? Why do we give him glory? Can you touch somebody next to you and tell him, because he's in this room right now? How you probably can't see him, you probably can't feel him, but you're sitting. See. Look at somebody behind you, tell him he's here right now. And tell him, because he's here, everything you need is here. I need all my worshipers, open up your mouth and give him glory right here. Oh, oh yeah, yeah. Come on, worshipers, lift up your voice. Come on, singers, come on. Come on, don't mute your worship. Oh, he's in the room. The King of Kings, we bow down. To the King of Kings, you're here right now. Be enthroned. To the King of Kings, we bow down. Be enthroned. I want y'all to say this, repeat, say, sit forever you are. Forever you are King. Forever you are me. Forever you are me. You're the everlasting God. Wonderful Counselor. You're a mighty God. And we give you glory. Let's go. Say the King of Kings. We bow down. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords is a strong tower, and the righteous running in the same. You are Jehovah. You are Jehovah. You are Jehovah. You are Jehovah. Yeah. For the Bible declares in Romans 12 and 1. That I beseech you therefore, brethren, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. I need somebody to lift up your hands and open up your mouth and give it what you know it deserves. Oh, come on, Jeffrey.
We say holy, acceptable, holy, acceptable, holy, acceptable. We give it to you, we give it all over the earth. Acceptable, receive our worship. Acceptable, receive our praise. Acceptable, yeah. We give you our heart, we give you our mind. We'll sing first your kingdom, your righteousness. We want to see you. Let's just say this. Come on, say, we lift this to you. We lift this to you. We lift this to you. We lift this to you.
We lift glory and honor. Dominion and power.
Yeah, yeah. It all goes to you.
Go to you.
We surrender again.
We'll
give it all up again. We surrender again. I need somebody to lift those hands. And oh my shaba. Bola siya na ba. Mano. We give it all over to you, Lord. Our issues, Father. Our bad habits, Father. We give it to you. We give it to you. Glory and honor, dominion and power. Glory and honor.
I've learned it doesn't matter how you come into the presence of God, but it's how you leave the presence of God. When we get into the presence of the King, Every one of our issues and worries are taken care of. What worship does is it takes my perspective off of what looks bad and turn my eyes to who I know is good. That when you get into the presence of the King, when you worship here, He'll work everything out at your address. I don't know how long you traveled. I don't know how much gas it took you to get here. But I just need somebody to give Him glory here. That when you lift Him up here, He'll work it out back at your house. When you... My worship ain't just for me. But your worship ought to affect your neighbor. That it may not be for me, but when I lift up my hands, I position a God to not just move for me, but move on everybody on my road. Is there any worship? Is there any worship? Just look at somebody next to you. Matter of fact, I wasn't gonna do it, Teddy, but can everybody grab somebody, squeeze their hand? Somebody needs some strength. This is the year we're not coming to church and leaving the same way we came. But I feel a miracle in the room. I said I feel a miracle in the room. While you're squeezing your neighbor's hand, just begin to pray for who's ever hand you're holding. God, I don't know what they're going through, but they won't leave the same way they get tonight. Oh, Basha, you might not have a higher experience, but thank God your neighbor is getting ready to have a God experience. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Push in the spirit. You can't look at this. You gotta tap in this. Come on, come on, come on. Break the hands of the enemy over your neighbor's life. Thank you.